Hi friends, this is Rakesh from Let's Make Learning Simple channel. Now we are going to discuss about singleton design pattern in a theoretical manner. In the next video, we will discuss about the singleton design pattern using some program. So this video is all about theoretical and real world examples. Next video is all about the program. So first, what is singleton pattern? So the name itself suggests that there is only one thing. That's a singleton means there is something that is which stands alone for one type. So here singleton means only one object. So only one object is an allow. If suppose if you are trying to create multiple objects for that class, JVM doesn't allow that. JVM allows only one object creation. That object would be reused by n number of times. That's the power of singleton. So you just imagine a scenario. If suppose if you are trying to create an object n number of times means, for example, consider that n equal to 5. So this is in memory. If you want to create 5 object means, first object, second object, third, fourth and fifth. So 5 object consume some considerable amount of memory. That can be avoided using singleton. But there are some rules. There are some rules when we should use singleton and when we shouldn't use singleton pattern. The first rule is, if suppose some objects has its own properties or own things means we shouldn't use singleton pattern. For example, consider this case, student learning equal to new student 1, 100. 1 is the roll number and 100 is the marks. Student Chenchu equal to new student 2, 100. Here Chenchu is the object, 2 is the roll number and 100 is the marks. Here 1, 100 is the specific properties are the specific properties for learning object. 2, 100 are the specific properties for the Chenchu object. So we shouldn't use singleton for these use cases, because if the object has its own or specific properties, then we shouldn't use singleton property. If object has its common properties, if suppose an object doesn't have any specific properties means, then we can use a singleton pattern. For example, we will try to cover that example in using real world examples in the later part of this video. So we will try to cover advantages of a singleton design pattern. Since JVM is allowing only one time object creation, then it is trying to save the memory. So in the previous part of the video, we would have discussed that if you want to create 5 objects means, then it consumes 5 object memory. But JVM allows only one object for singleton. So only one object. So the remaining 4 object memory can be used for other purposes. So it saves memory. The second point is performance improvement. So performance improvement in this sense, for creating object, it needs some amount of CPU. The object consumes that memory and performance improvement. So these are the 2 major advantages and main advantages of using singleton design pattern. And then we will try to cover this implementation details in a detailed manner in the upcoming videos. For now, just consider that if you want to implement singleton pattern means, then the class constructor should be private. So we would have discussed about the public constructors in the previous videos, but to implement singleton pattern, the class constructors, all the constructors should be private. So that's important point. Now we will try to cover this part in a detailed manner using programs in the upcoming video. Please try to take a brief thing from this part. And then real world examples. So many have asked me regarding the Java course. So they ask me, why can't you teach me Java course? So I said that I have already spent a lot of time and effort for making a course, Java course. I hosted the Java course videos on YouTube. So please try to go and watch that video. So here, that JVM is the environment. I am the object. So many people are trying to ask JVM to create new object. But JVM is saying that already one object is created that can be reused. So please try to reuse that like that. So I am the object. So only one object is created. That one object is reused many times. So I am the source for the object. So I am my object. Only one time object creation. So only one time I'm going to post a video, that video is watched by n times. N times is the n number of times, n use cases where that object's help is needed. So here the object has don't have the specific properties, so it has a common property, so it can be used by any number of times. That's a that's the real time use case of singleton. And then Java has many singleton implementations. The one of the important implementations is runtime class. So runtime class is the singleton design pattern implemented class. So only one object is created for the JVM. So you can use n number of times. So if suppose if you are trying to ask to create a new object, means it will try to give the already created object. So this is the real time use case where Java is using singleton design pattern. So thanks for watching this video. Please try to watch the next video also, because in the next video we will try to cover, we have covered the practical implementation of singleton design pattern. Thanks once again. Please try to subscribe my channel.